Well, howdy, 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 folks. I'm glad to be here. Hope you are too. I want to talk about how much ice to bring to your cart and where to use ice, because a lot of people do this by trial and error. It's why I have a link right there. It's the top 40 questions I get asked, but oftentimes they're missed, and it's trial and error, and it's trial by fire, and that was me when I started. I was trial by fire, and I just didn't know exactly what to do, how to do it, and I just learned as I went. Well, I could have saved myself a lot of headaches, a lot of extra work, had I known some of these things. And so if you look at these top 40, you're going to cover a lot of stuff, and some of it you're going to go, well, my God, that's just self-explanatory. But then there's other things you're going to go, I'm glad he told me that. Well, let me tell you about ice real quick, okay? I'm talking about the cold stuff, cold water, right? So with that, most people think when they first get started, got to have ice on my cart, right? Got to put ice in the cooler. Most carts come with a cooler, but most carts are also an oven, okay? And even though they're not used as an oven, the cart gets warm, especially in the summer, but either way, you have burners going, you have stuff going, and the cart gets warm. It's why our carts have that triple insulation between the burner unit, but it still gets warm. But there is an onboard cooler. That means inside the cart. That cooler, most people think, well, I'll just dump a bunch of ice to keep my stuff cold. Well, the problem is ice melts, okay? And even though you're only out there for 2 or 3 hours, the ice melts, and it makes everything else nasty, right? So then you have to worry about a drain, and does the drain go to a gray tank and all the stuff. And so I teach to never use ice there, ever, ever, ever. There's never a reason to have ice in there. You take your frozen goods, your frozen hot dogs, your frozen stuff, and you put it in there. And this is your cooler. It's not your customer stuff. I'm not talking drinks. I know a lot of, here's how you can tell if people have vended before. They'll sell you a cart and they'll say, the drinks go in here. No, they don't. That's impossible. Unless you're vending for 10 people, you ain't going to get your drinks in there. So when I go out, I was taking 100, 150 drinks, sometimes 300, depending on the location. Well, you put that many drinks in there, you ain't got room for your stuff. So I like to have my stuff handy right in front of me. So I just reach over, open the cooler, grab another pack of dogs, slide them into the heat, right? I've already got them in Ziploc bags, but what I'll use in there is instant, like, ice packs, gel packs, freezer packs, and you can find the commercial ones, okay? I even have a page where you can find all this stuff for vendors. It's called learnhotdogs.com/resources. And it's just a bunch of stuff people have submitted, good prices, good places to buy stuff. And so that's just one avenue. But you can use Google, too. It's a new thing they've come out with. So anyway, you punch it in, look for ice packs, gel packs, commercial freezer packs, that kind of stuff that are reusable. Those are great ones, right? So, and you line your cooler inside with it and throw your frozen stuff in there. If you could leave it there for days and it'd stay frozen. So, and most health inspectors are looking for no moisture, and ice creates moisture. They're looking for no moisture, and they're looking for the right temp. They want the temp below, typically below 42, but sometimes they'll tell you below 39. So in your cooler. Now then, what do you do for drinks? What do you do? That's where you need ice. Ice needs to be used in your drinks because it is eye candy, right? It's what attracts you to see all these bottles of soda or cans of soda and root beer and stuff laid out there in ice. Some vendors, they'll use galvanized tubs filled with ice and drinks and stuff. They'll layer it, though. They'll put a layer of drinks, then a layer of ice, another layer of drinks, another layer of ice. And that way, as people take stuff, they work down to the next layer, and it just keeps it cold. Now, what do you do if you only have one or two coolers and you do a lot of volume and you're going, oh, my gosh, I need to get drinks cold fast. Another tip for ice. You ever made homemade ice cream the old way, you know, the cranky, cranky way? You do that with salt. Salt just is like magic. It's like unicorn dust. And so you sprinkle the salt in there. You can use rock salt, table salt. Doesn't matter what kind of salt you use. Okay, they'll tell you it does, but it doesn't. They even sell ice cream salt. Go figure, right? So, and for my front step salt and all that stuff, it's all salt. So put salt in there and stir it around. And because as your ice melts, that will super chill those drinks, especially if you're using aluminum can drinks. So it will make them cold, really, really freaking fast. So the ice and salt react and lowers the freezing point of the ice. Ice melts super fast and it gets super cold. I'm talking super cold. And so that's a great tip for you to use if you need to really chill some drinks. It could be something as simple as, hey, I ran out of Diet Pepsi and I'm going to throw 6 cans in a cooler real quick with some ice and salt. You will have some cold Pepsis in about 3 minutes. So those are things, that's where you need to use your ice, is in your drinks. That's it, because it's for display. Even if you keep the lid shut, they're going to open it and it's eye candy, ice and soda. That's ice soda or whatever. So anyway, I love you. Hope that helps. I'll talk to you later. If you have a question, feel free to put it in the comments or hit me up on the email at ben@learnhotdogs.com. But if you're just getting started or you're about to get ready to get started, start looking at some of these videos here. They're all videos. They're easy and they're broke down into 5 questions each. learnhotdogs.com/40 for 40 top 40 questions new vendors ask. Okay? Anyway, hope that helps. Love you. Bye.